हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल डीएस टेक मिरर। दिस इज पार्ट 10 ऑफ आवर एसपीएफएक्स ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी हाउ टू बिल्ड एमएस टीम्स टैब यूजिंग शेयरपॉइंट फ्रेमवर्क। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। सो गाइस, दिस इज माय एमएस टीम्स। इन दिस यू कैन सी आई हैव वेरियस टीम्स। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी विल सी हाउ टू क्रिएट दीज टीम्स टैब। एट द टॉप यू कैन सी वेरियस टैब्स लाइक पोस्ट, फाइल्स एंड विकी। सो हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट दिस कस्टम टैब यूजिंग शेयरपॉइंट फ्रेमवर्क। सो आई एम डायरेक्टली जंपिंग इन टू माई Visual Studio Code. So guys, I have already opened up Visual Studio solution. So you can take any web part of your choice you want to deploy it as MS Teams tab. This is my CRUD operation web part. You can see, I will show you in the browser. So this is my web part. I will deploy this web part as a MS Teams tab. So let's see what are the steps involved to deploy this web part as an MS Teams tab. So guys, the very first step which you will be doing is to go to your webpart manifest file. So the webpart manifest file is present under source folder. Under source, you can see you have this webpart folder. So my webpart name is React CRUD. So you can see over here, this is React CRUD webpart.manifest.json file. So I have already explained this file in this tutorial. So open your webpart manifest.json file. In this file, just look for this supported host property. You can see over here this supported host, and over here the value is SharePoint web part. So now this web part can be deployed as a SharePoint web part. So now we want to deploy it as an MS Teams tab. So I will put comma, and you can see now I have properties which are available. That is SharePoint full page. That is if you want to deploy your SPFX web part as SharePoint full page, SharePoint web part, Teams personal app and Teams tab. So I will select Teams tab because I want to deploy it as an MS Teams tab. So now this is done. Now what I will do, one more thing I want to show you. Go to your component file, react-crud.txs file. Now let's say when you are in MS Teams, you want to perform some other operation or you want to display a different message, and when you are under SharePoint you want to deploy a different message. So how you can do that? That is like you have this context available with us. So I already told you about the webpart context which is available under my webpart.ts file. So this is my webpart.ts file, and this is the context which is available, that is this dot context, and we are passing this context to our component using React properties. So I will directly go to the component file. So in this, what I will do, I'll put one if condition. If now my context is in, I told you we have passed it through the to my TSX file using properties, that is props of the React. So this dot props dot context now dot. So now from here it will start context dot SDKs dot, just remember SDKs dot and Microsoft Teams. So now it is telling me, if this is true, then I am inside my MS Teams, else I am inside the SharePoint because only two supported hosts are there over there. So this is my else condition. So what I will do, just to test for the context, I am also creating one variable of type string, that is my message. In this, what I will do, I will display a different message based on my deployment, which means when my web part will be under MS Teams, it will display a different message, and when the same web part will be deployed in SharePoint, it will display me a different message. So what I have done, I created this message and it is blank right now. So what I'm saying is this dot props dot context dot SDK dot Microsoft Teams. Now if I'm under MS Teams, message should be, I will display a message, let's say welcome to Teams tab, and when I'm under SharePoint, message will be welcome to SPFX web part, let's say SharePoint web part, welcome to SPFX Teams tab and welcome to SPFX SharePoint web part. So these are two different messages which will get displayed differently in MS Teams and SharePoint. So now what I have to do, I will do a simple step. I will just display it in my render method. So this is my render, and inside this return, what I will do, I will display it in my title. So this is my title, guys. You can see this is my title. So what I will do, instead of displaying right now, you can see this is showing me message welcome to DS Tech Mirror at the top. Now instead of displaying welcome.dstechmirror, what I will do, I will display this message. So I will remove welcome.dstechmirror from here, and I want to display this message, and I will say message. To display the message, I use this curly quotes, and inside this I put this my variable message. So now the first important step is, in the webpart manifest.json file, you have to put Teams tab in the supported host. The second thing is, in case you have any requirement which you have to implement in MS Teams tab, you can use this dot, basically it is context.sdk.microsoft.teams, and then you can perform your operation inside your if condition. So this is the first step. Now as a next step, what I will do, I will create a package and I will deploy this SPFS webpart in my tenant app catalog. So I will go to the terminal. First of all, I will create a bundle, gulp bundle hyphen hyphen ship, and then I will create a package, gulp package hyphen solution hyphen hyphen ship. So gulp bundle hyphen hyphen ship. Now this command will create a bundle for me, and after that I will create a package as I told you. So now my gulp bundle is finished. As a next step, I will create a package for this solution. So command is gulp package hyphen solution hyphen hyphen ship. So once my package is ready, we will upload this package in my app catalog, that is tenant level app catalog. I will wait for the package to get created. So this is also done, my package is ready. So now what I will do, I will go to my app catalog. So guys, this is my app catalog, apps for SharePoint. Now I will upload the sppkg file over here. So let me go to my solution and the file explorer. So my package is present in inside my SharePoint folder. This is my SharePoint folder and this is my demo1.sppkg file. So I'll go to the file explorer. So this is my package file. I will upload this in my tenant level app catalog. So now deployment is in progress. It is saying this client solution will get context from the following domain, SharePoint online. That is completely fine. Deploy. So guys, deployment is done. So now few important steps we have to do before this webpart will be available in my MS Teams. First of all, select this newly created webpart, go to the files in the ribbon and click this button that is sync to team. What it will do, it will sync my this webpart to my MS Teams. Just remember that MS Teams has a separate app catalog. So what it will do, sync to Teams, it will create a, automatically it will create a manifest file, webpart manifest file for my MS Teams, and it will upload the webpart in the MS Teams app catalog, which is not accessible to us. So I will click on sync to Teams. Now successfully synced team solution. Now one more step we have to do, we have to deploy this webpart to one of the site collection. We have two options, either we deploy it to the entire tenant, or we have to deploy to one particular site. So what I will do, I have not deployed it to the entire tenant. So what I will do, I will go to a particular site. I will go to my site POC site and I will deploy this webpart in this site, and then it will be available to us in MS Teams. So I'm in my POC site. I will go to the site contents and I will add an app. New app. It will be C, demo one client side solution. You can see this is demo one client side solution. Now I will add this to my site. It will take some time to get deployed to the site, and then I will add it to in my page. So now this is also done, this is available. I will go to my page now, SPFX webpart page, and over here I will add that webpart. I will edit the page from here. I will add, that is demo one. So guys, my webpart name is React CRUD. It is coming with the name of the React CRUD webpart. You can see over here. So my webpart name is React CRUD. That's why it is coming with the name React CRUD, and my solution name is demo solution. So now I will go and add this webpart, that is React CRUD. And you can see same webpart is available over here. Now I will publish the page. So now I have successfully added this webpart in my SharePoint. First important thing to notice is it is giving me a message, welcome to SPFX SharePoint webpart. That is, my context is working absolutely fine. Now what I will do, I will go to my MS Teams and I will add this webpart as a team step. So guys, now I will open my Microsoft Teams. So what I will do, I am in my portal.office.com. From here I will click on Teams and I will open the Teams in my web app. Now my Teams is ready. So what I will do, I've already synced my solution with the MS Teams. Now I will go to the apps. I'm in my apps, and you can see over here you will get a message that is built for your tenant name. So this is my tenant name, and over here you can see my app, that is React CRUD, is available now. So now what I will do, I will go to my any of my channel and I will add it as a Teams tab. For that, what I will do, I will click on Teams from the left navigation, and from here I'll select this POC. Under general, I will come over here as I show you in the beginning of this video. Now over here I will click on this plus sign. This is one of to add a new tab, and over here I will search. So you can see over here React CRUD is available. I will click on it. It is giving me a message, save, post to the channel about this tab, save. And now it is adding this my SPFX web part in my Teams tab. And you can see my web part is available as a Teams tab in my channel. My channel name is POC under general. So guys, we have successfully added our SPFX web part in my Teams as a tab. So over here you can see you have got all the capabilities which you are getting in your SharePoint also. Another important point over here is you can see the message at the top, welcome to SPFX Teams tab. And the same web part when I will open in my SharePoint, I can say welcome to SPFX SharePoint web part. So this is the message over here in my code. When I write this code, see over here we have written two different messages. In case of team, welcome to SPFX Teams tab, and in case if the context is not SharePoint, in our case else is the SharePoint, so message is welcome to SPFX SharePoint web part. So guys, over here you can also see that my context is also working properly fine. So in case you have any requirement specifically related to MS Teams, so you can use this piece of code, that is this dot, basically it is context.sdk.microsoft teams, because we are using React, and in React component I have passed my context, web part context through properties. So I am using this dot props dot context dot sdk dot microsoft team. Okay, so now again I will go to my MS Teams in my web, and I will show you again. So this is fine. You can also see my office UI fabric React drop down is also working fine, and from here you can perform any of your operation. So guys, another last very important point I would like to highlight over here is I have added this solution in SharePoint to my POC site, and over here you can see this is my POC Teams, and under POC in general, if I click on here three dots, if I open this team, so basically every channel and every team in Teams has a SharePoint team site at the back end. So if I open this site, it is the same site POC on which I have already deployed my web part. So important point which I want to highlight is, if you are deploying your web part globally, that is at tenant level, then there is no need to add your deployer web part specifically on a website. But if you are, so the point is guys, while creating the web part solution over here, you can see the setting. Do you want to allow the tenant admin the choice of being able to deploy the solution to all the solutions immediately without running any feature deployment? So if you keep this setting as yes, your web part, SPFX web part, the moment you will upload it on a app catalog, over here you will, in the dialog you will get a message to deploy this web part throughout your tenant. So the moment you select it, your web part will automatically will get deployed to all your site in the site collection, and you can add your web part in any of your Teams channel. But if you are not doing tenant level deployment, if you are just deploying it to a specific site collection, then you have to specifically go to your site and add your web part, and you can only add your web part to the corresponding channel. So for example, if I'll go to this SPFX and Teams integration, if I click on it and I'll say, if I try to add this web part under this tab, add, see, I'm getting this error. Sorry, something went wrong. Can't load the application on this page because this channel has a separate team site. If I click on this again, if I open in SharePoint, see, it is having a separate team site, SPFX and Teams integration. So if I want to add my web part as a tab in this channel, in this team, so I have to go and add my web part. I have to go and deploy my SPFX web part in this SharePoint site, and then only I can add into this particular Teams tab. So this is the basic difference. If I want to add to, if I want the freedom to add my web part in any of the team, I have to select this setting as yes, and then there's no need to go to individual site and add deployer web part. So guys, just keep this in mind. So guys, that's it for today's video. If you like this video, please like the video and subscribe to the channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon. If you face any issue related to this video or any of my previous video, you can reach out to us through our official email ID, that is contactdstechmirror@gmail.com. I have created a group on Facebook. You can join that group also. Link is in my description box as well. Also, you can follow me on Twitter to get all the updates from the Office 365 world. Till then, much love. Keep learning. Thank you.